Another guy who did gain some offensive line support, I still don't know if I'm going to go back to this guy, but that's Le'Veon Bell. The Jets do make it a clear focus that, you know, Joe Douglas of the Eagles, his whole philosophy is building the line first. They select that mauling Mekhi Becton from Louisville in round one, and then they add some other beef to George Fant, a new center. They add some field stretchers, Breshad Perriman and Denzel Mims, and they also bring in Frank Gore's corpse. Adam Gase is still there. I don't know. What do you think of Le'Veon Bell next year?
I mean, it's not looking good at all. Gase has never backed up this. Gase has been like publicly mad ever since he got the job about them giving Bell so much money. I mean, Le'Veon, to his credit, he's saying good things for the most part. Like, yeah, when they just let Robbie walk and things, you know, maybe he's not the most happy guy, but I don't know, Jamal Adams and Le'Veon, like, it's almost like Gase wants to make these guys out to be problems. They just go out there and play really hard. I mean, I know last year sucked for Le'Veon, but, you know, as you said, he was playing behind one of the worst offensive lines in the league by far. Still did good things when he was asked to kind of split out in the slot and go play outside, which I always thought was what separated him from other running backs in his time in Pittsburgh. I mean, truly just an amazing receiver. And the problem is, man, it might be Frank Gore's corpse, but clearly they wouldn't have signed him if they didn't have the intention of giving Gore 100-plus touches. Even this rookie running back they drafted, he's kind of more of a scat back, so that could take away from Bell's targets. Man, it's like even just one interview of Adam Gase saying, you know what, we really think Le'Veon's a great talent. You know, we're excited to have him as our starting running back. Maybe then I could change my mind, but as this is, looks like a committee mess. I mean, Bell's in a situation where, you know, we've seen Adam Gase just trade away Jay Ajayi, you know, six games into the year. It's a volatile situation. Give me Jameson Crowder for how cheap is. You know, give me Chris Herndon at the bottom of the tight end barrel. Yeah. Using a top 20 RB pick on Le'Veon, no thanks.
Absolutely. I'm in full agreement with you there. I mean, I feel like I was writing an article like 3 years ago, Frank Gore's corpse isn't going to impact Kenyon Drake. And yet Drake could never be unleashed because Gore was there taking all the goal line touches. The corpse of Gore has been the corpse for like 10 years. And he's still, I hate to say it because he is still such a hard runner and he's still getting it done. I mean, the guy's still a beast. I don't mean any disrespect to one of the best, you know, runners out there, but it is true. Gase has had this guy ruin people's values before. I'm more nervous about it than I think many are, and I'm not touching it. I'm not touching that backfield. I like the guys you cited there. Those are really the only two pieces I want of the Jets.